Thank you very much for the introduction. And I also like to thank organizers also, and KIAS for the support. This talk about the p-adic code and also the lift of the code is based on the following papers. And the first one is the Kaldebank and Sloan modular and p-adic cyclic code. They show the way of constructing p-adic code in 1995. So, and after 10 years, Dori and Kim, she was a student of mine, and we published a paper about the lifted code and the with enumerators. And next year, Dori and I published also a code, in a paper about the code of p-adic integers. In this paper, we computed weight enumerators of the lifted code of binary Golay code of length 24. But the calculation was not complete. And then it was maybe 2010 or so, I talked about it to Song Yuhan and ask him to complete the calculation, and he come up with a very good algorithm to compute weight enumerators for a given weight. And so that was complete in some sense, but that was also my the motivation to look more of the codes. Okay, so I'll talk about the code of G P to the E, and then next talk about the p-adic integers and p-adic codes. And the quadratic residue codes are a very good example for liftings and the weight enumerators. And section 5, I'll talk about how to compute weight enumerators for the lifted code. And then I'll give you examples. Okay, so modular code, or just the code of GM, is again the submodule of GM to the end. And Hamming weight is again the number of non-zero components. And it gives a distance and the minimum distance of a code. And the inner product is defined as usual by the standard inner product. And the self-dual code is also the same as before, over the field. And then the generator matrix of a code is also defined over the ring G PE. The vectors V1 through VK are said to be modulo independent if summation AI VI equals 0 implies that all AI are non-units. And then those words form a basis for C if they are modulo independent and generate C. And then the K by N matrix consisting of this basis will be a generator matrix. And then the generator matrix for C pop is the parity chain matrix. Any matrix over GPE can be transformed into this kind of this form. This is called the standard form. So the diagonal elements are either 1, p, p squared, etc. And we say that the type of the matrix will be the number of one, I mean one to the number of ones in the diagonal, and p to the number of p's in k, the diagonal, etc. But this notation is not standard. Someone used like this, or even like this. So we have to be careful who is talking. Oops, one section. Okay. Okay, I'll introduce you the p-adic numbers. Maybe many of you know about this, and also maybe many of you do not know about this. So fix the prime number p, and for any non-zero r in q, we can write equals p to the k times a over b, where a and b are relative prime to p, and then the absolute value of the p-adic absolute value of r is defined by p to the minus k. So, for example, 2-adic absolute value of 2 is 1/2. 2-adic absolute value of 1/2 is 2. And then this defines a metric. Sorry. This defines a metric on Q, and we can complete this Q with respect to this metric, and we obtain the field of p-adic numbers. And that's the set of these elements. So this is a power series in P, but there can be a negative negative powers. The subring G P infinity is defined to be every element in QP which has absolute value less than or equal to 1, and that has this kind of form. So this starts from A0 and then A1P plus A2P squared, etc., where AI is between 0 and P minus 1. This ring is called the ring of p-adic integers, and this is a principal ideal domain. And actually, the standard notation in number theory is GP, so we cannot use this. And this is the notation Kaldebank and Sloan used in their paper for the first time. GP infinity, the ring of integers, also can be defined as the inverse limit of the system, like this, where these maps are modular maps. So this is the algebraic way to define it, and if you define this way, by definition, two numbers, two p-adic numbers are equal if and if they are equal a modulo p to the e pole e. And it's a very, very famous theorem by Ostrakovsky that every metric on Q is actually one of these p-adic absolute value or the usual absolute value. So the p-adic absolute values are as important as the usual absolute value. The usual absolute value is in fact one of many absolute values. and the product formula holds, and Hasse-Minkowski theorem is the R is a square in Q if and only if R is a square in QP for all of P. So let me show you some surprise, or it will be fun to look at this one. For example, if you add 1, 2, 2 square, 2 cube to the infinity, and you know, it's just the formula for the geometric series. 1 over 1 minus 2 is minus 1. And this one composes only in Q2 because absolute value 2 is 1 half. And that's less than 1. And also, in QP, where P is finite, the summation, the series summation AN converges if and only if the limit is 0. So this is called the freshman stream. And we have a non-Archimedean property of this. A plus B has absolute value less than or equal to the maximum of these two. And any element in the sphere is at the center of the sphere. And in Q5, there is a negative, the square root of minus 1. In fact, minus 1 is the square in QP, if and only P equals 1 modulo 4. So, in some sense, C is not the only one who has the square root of minus 1. There are many here. Okay. Here again, the any code over the p-adic integers has a generator matrix equivalent to one of these forms. It's very similar in the case of GPE. But something is different from the finite case, and that is that the C pop to the pop is not always equal to C. This only holds for the type 1k. In other words, the diagonals are all one type. In particular, self-dual code satisfies this, so any self-dual code will have a type 1 to the k. So we only will consider a p-adic code of type 1 to the k because I'm interested in the self-dual codes. Psi e will be the usual modulo function, taking the modulo function. And then now I'll define what the lift is. So suppose that we have a code over G to the P E1 and a code C2 over G P to P to the E2, where E1 is less than or equal to E2. We say that C1, C2 lifts, C2 is a lift of C1, or C1 lifts to C2, if the generator matrix of C2 is congruent to a generator matrix of C1 modulo P to the E1. So, if you have a p-adic code, if you have a p-adic code and project to a GPE by this map, for every E, we get a series of lifts of the code, and all will have a type 1 to k, because I'm assuming that C has a type 1 k.
Type 1 k is just free?
Yeah, free. Conversely, if C is NK code over GP, and we, let's say G denote G by A0, and then take any matrix of the size NK, kn, like this, and take ge to be a0 plus pa1 plus p square a2, etc. Then this will be a generator matrix of a code over gpe, and obviously this is congruent to a0, which is g modulo p, therefore that code is lift of c. And if you do that, if you do this for the infinite stage, to the infinite stage, we get a p-adic generator matrix. Therefore, in some sense, p-adic code is just the same as a series of lifts from a code of a GP. I'll give you some results on p-adic self-dual codes. First, for p not equal to 2, self-dual code exists over gp infinity if and only if n is equal to 0 mod 4 if p is congruent to 3 mod 4, and n is 0 mod 2 if p is 1 mod 4. So this is same as the case for gp. And for the prime 2, self-dual code exists over g to infinity if and only if the length is a multiple of 8. 1 and 2 is actually part of this 3 and 4, in some sense. Self-dual code over G2 lifts to a self-dual code over G to infinity, if and only if. Every code word has weight divisible by 4. But for P not equal to 2, any self-dual code over GP can be lifted to a self-dual code of P at the integers. And contrary to the finite case, many MDS codes exist over the p-adic integers. Here, MDS code means the minimum distance is equal to n minus k plus 1, and also type 1 to the k. Now, let's say again, will be a p-adic nk codes of type 1k, and ghb, the generator matrix, and parity check matrix, and c to the e, g sub e, h sub e, will be the code and the generator and parity check matrix of ce, and d will denote the minimum distance of dc1, in other words, the c mod p. And the infinity will be the minimum distance of C. C is the p-adic code. C1 is the code of GP. Note that we have a well-defined map from GP e to the nth power to the GP to the e plus 1 to the nth power, defined by B. Goes to PB, and we have also the backward map PB from here to V. This is well defined, so we can always go up by multiplying by P, or can go down by canceling P if there is a P. Now, if I have a code word in CE and multiply by P, we get a code word on CE to the 1, E plus 1. And if B is the form P times some vector, like this, then B0 will be CE minus 1, and conversely. This is very easy to see, but it will be very useful. For example, if I have a vector of minimum distance, you just multiply every component by p, then you get a code word with d in c2, etc. So the minimum distance is actually equal to d for every e. But the infinity, in other words, the minimum distance of the p-adic chord is at least d, but it can go up more than d. Okay, as I told you, this quadratic radius chord fields are very important examples for the weight enumerators calculation in my situation, and there are many examples also. So let me define the quadratic radius chord of a field and a GPE and PAD integers. So over the fields, this construction is very well known. You can find in any coding book. So n will be a prime, representing length of a chord, and we need another prime, which is quadratic residue mod n. So this p will be a base, will give you a base field, and also we need a primitive nth root of unity in some extension of GP. Then Q denotes quadratic residue modulo n, and n denotes quadratic non-residue modulo n. And define a polynomial Qx and nx by like this. Qx is the product of x minus alpha I for I in Q. So every quadratic residue, and similarly for nx. Then x to the nth power minus 1 factors into x minus 1 times qx times nx. You know, this one is not a polynomial in qx in an obvious way, but because p is in the quadratic residue, if you replace alpha by alpha to the p-th power, the qx just stays there. So, in other words, qx and nx are fixed by the Frobenius automorphism. That means that these two polynomials are actually in the field. And this these q and n are not necessarily irreducible. Then the quadratic residue chords, we define a four quadratic residue chords usually, Q, Q1, and N, and 1. These are cyclic chords with a generator matrix, either Qx, x minus 1 times Qx, Nx, x minus 1 times Nx. And there are many nice properties about this quadratic residue chord, and I'm especially interested in this one. In other words, the extended chords, Q hat and N hat. These two chords are self-dual if P is congruent to minus 1 mod 4. The extension is not always by the checked tech digit, but there is a little bit of a twist here. And these extended chords are important because the automorphism group is very large. It contains PSL2N. And there's important codes like Hamming code of length 7, binary code, a ternary Golay code of length 11, binary Golay code of length 23 are all QR quadratic residue codes. And also you can find this formula for idempotent generators. Where theta is a square root of minus n in GP when n equals 4k minus 1. N can be 4k plus 1 or minus 1, but because of self-duality, I only consider this case. We can do the similar thing to our quadratic residue chord over GPE for any e. And the settings are exactly the same as before. N is the length prime number, and another prime p, which is quadratic residue mod p, and alpha is also n through 2 unit in some extension of GPE, q and n are the same, and qe at any, just defined by the same formula. And because this ring over GPE is a Galois extension, with the Oron-Pichin group generated by, again, by this map, that implies that this factorization is again the factorization in GPE. So these two are in polynomial in GPE. So we can define exactly the same way. To define something about quadratic residue code over p-adic integers, I'd like to say something about Hansel lemma. That's a very important tool in p-adic numbers. So suppose f(x) is a polynomial in GP infinity x. Well, usually f(x) will be polynomial in gx. And suppose that there is a root of f, a modulo p. And also suppose that prime beta 1 is not equal to 0 mod p. Then there is a unique p-adic integer, beta, such that f beta equals 0. And also this beta is congruent to beta 1 mod p. So this is called the Hessel-Lipto of this beta 1. To solve this inequality, this equation, you need to solve this equation modulo p first. And if you find the root, you just check this condition holds. If this condition holds, then you have a unique p-adic root, which is congruent to modulo beta 1. So here's the example. X squared plus x plus 6 equals 0 has solutions in mod 2, 3, and 13 like this. And a prime beta is 2 beta plus 1. And that's not equal to 0 in any of this. Therefore, fx equals 0 has two roots in G infinity for any p equals 2, 3, or 13. And we need the polynomial version of the Hensel's lemma. Suppose that we have a polynomial in GPEX or GP to the infinity X, which is monic. And suppose that we have a factorization like that on mod P. Here, GIs are all pairwise relatively prime polynomials. Then there is the unique pairwise relatively prime polynomials, GIEX in GPEX, such that f is equal to this product, where g1e is congruent to g1x, g2ex is congruent to g2x mod p. Again, this polynomial will be called the Hensel-Lipto of this.
You don't have a degree condition. You don't want the degrees to be preserved.
Degree? That's enough to ask a polynomial for money.
I could have term like p squared.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So we take the same degree polynomial. Okay. So in practice, we leave to d1 to g. GP2 and GP3, etc. by using Euclidean algorithm. So this was the example yesterday, I mean Patrick Soleil gave yesterday. And it goes up to the infinity like this. So this was the polynomial I just solved before. The idea of portal generators looks like exactly the same, with the same equation like this. So now we define the quadratic residue code of p-adic integers. The settings are really exactly the same, and definitions exactly the same as before. So I guess everybody now memorized this. Now I'm going to give you the idea portent generators for this code. So we need some considerations on the equation. Suppose that n equals 4k minus 1. This is, again, we need for the self-dual codes. Suppose the lambda and mu be the roots of x squared plus x plus k equals 0 in GPE. And theta be root of x squared equals minus 1 in GPE, infinity. Then theta is plus minus lambda minus mu, and lambda is can be solved by two, theta minus 1 over 2, and mu will be minus theta minus 2. So lambda and mu and theta determine each other in GPE, GPE infinity. Actually, this equation, theta squared equals minus n, is always solvable, and because when p is not equal to 2, minus n over p is 1, this shows the computation. So minus n is a square mod p, and then we can use Hansel lemma, and ensure that there are two solutions, theta in GP infinity, or p not equal to 2. But when p equals 2, first 2 must be a quadratic residue modulo n, so that implies that n equals plus 8 out plus minus 1. Also, theta squared is minus 1 in p is 2 here, GP 2 to infinity, if n or minus n is congruent to 1 mod 8. So for the code, for the p-adic integers over mod prime 2, that's the theorem. So n has to be 8 out minus 1 to satisfy 1 and 2. But something strange happens here, because theta squared equals minus n mod 2 to the e for finite e has 4 solutions because of this structure. But only 2 solutions in g to the infinity. In other words, having a solution in gp infinity to the infinity doesn't give you all solutions of this modulo 2 to the e. Now the elementary symmetric polynomials are defined like this, and the ith power symmetric polynomials are defined like this. And then there is a very useful Newton's identity which expresses the PI as the in terms of elementary symmetric polynomials, and that's the formula. Now let Q be the set of quadratic residues and listed Q1, Q2, etc., Q2T, and define Si alpha Q to be Si alpha to the Q1, alpha to the Q2, etc. Same for the Pi. Then Pi alpha to the Q is either lambda or mu. When I is in Q as lambda and I is n, not quadratic non-residue, then that's mu, and if it's equal to minus lambda minus 1. So because Q infinity x, which is the product of this, is the is given by this, here Si is the symmetric polynomials, and we can use the Newton's identity to solve the coefficients of the Qx. So let T to be n minus 1 over 2, and Qp infinity x be a0 x to the t power, etc. Then the first leading term is 1, and the second term is minus lambda. And the other ais can be determined inductively by this formula, where pi, is, we know that is either lambda or mu, so it just mu is also minus lambda minus 1, so you can plug in every stage. You get ai, and it turns out that every ai has the form ai plus b, where a, b are integers. Okay, so I give you an example here. When n equals 23, equals 4k minus 1 and k equals 6. Now the quadratic residue mod 23 is this. So the prime we can take is either 2, 3, or 13. No other primes here. Lambda will be root of x squared plus x plus 6. And a0 is 1, a1 is minus lambda. And here a formula for a2. And you plug in for the known values, you get this. And also a3 is minus this over 3, and everything is now known. So you plug in there, and you get minus 4, and you go on. And you get the generated polynomial for the quadratic residue code, like this. So this is the, well, we have the case, three cases for prime, 2, 3, or 13. When you take this for 2, you get quadratic residue code over binary quadratic residue code, and if you take 3, you get totally, etc. So once you know the Q infinity x, of course, n infinity x is obtained by replacing lambda by mu. So now we know all these four generators over the p-adic integers. So take this polynomial's modulo p to the eth, and the lambda and mu will be a root of this modulo p to the eth power. And it can be any number. Then we obtain all quadratic residue codes over GPE for p equals 2, 3, and 13.
Why
13?
Why 13? Why don't you go for 5 or 7?
Oh, these are not the quadratic residues of with 13, 23. You know, p must be quadratic residue. Okay. Here I give you the identity. I mean the idempotent generators of these codes with this formula, and the binary case. For the binary case, this generated the idempotent polynomials are given in the paper by Kaldemann and Sloan with theta here. But as I told you before, for binary case, we cannot reduce this to modulo p to the 2 to the east power, because theta doesn't work for the binary case. So we have to be careful about that. And there are some several authors who define a quadratic radical of p to the e by giving the idempotent generators. So this was the first one generalizing the quadratic radical over G4. They define by giving the idempotent generators, and then they extend the result to G8 in 2000 and G9 in 2009 and 2005 by Kim, who was my student, and 10 by 10 quadratic radical over G to the 2m in 2011. But it's very difficult to keep track of all these idempotent generators. So there is no way to memorize that. But if you know that this universal idempotent, the p-adic, for the p-adic code, we can take that polynomial and take the modulo to the necessary one. We get all the idempotent generators like this. So here we can use any of this. Either we can use b to mu over n, c to minus lambda over n, or we can use this one too. But for binary case, that doesn't work. I mean, the formula for theta, involving theta, does not work. So for a binary case, we need to use this formula. So again, that gives all idempotent generators for G8. And we can extend this quadratic radical by adding one bit. And this is the C infinity is added by this formula. And by these two conditions, we can see that for a prime n equals 4k minus 1, and another prime p, which is a quadratic residue margin, the extended QR code is self-dual MDS code, length n plus 1, with minimal distance n plus 3 over 2. So this minimum distance is quite large, because this is MDS code. And this is the best, of course. To define, I mean, to calculate the weight enumerators, we need Meg-Williams identity or the collision type theorem, like this. So you need k c. C zero to c k unknown variables here. So we need to determine these CIs. So we need k plus 1 conditions on this. Because of time, I'll give you a quick way to solve this problem. Let's just say that we have a p-adic code of type 1k and hp, the parasitic matrix. And for any subset of d elements, let's say hs be the submatrix whose columns are ith columns of H, like this. Then in the standard form of HS will look like this, for J to be minus infinity, 0, 1, etc. But here, P3 minus infinity, 0. What's important is the 1, there are D minus 1, 1s here, and only 1 P to the J. Let mu J be the number of subsets for which H has the type like that. then the minimum distance, number of minimum distance in CE is given by this formula. And then you can see from here, if there is an F, exponent F, such that ADF equals ADF plus 1, then the ADE is equal to ADF for all E. And also, D infinity is greater than D. In other words, the minimum distance of p-adic code is greater than the minimum distance of the projection to any finite GPE, if and only if D minus infinity is equal to 0. And then I show that there is some integer n, such that for all e greater than or equal to n, the number of code words in GPE of weight j is equal to this fixed one here, for j from d to d infinity minus 1. And here's another theorem that says that if AI F is equal to AI plus 1 for all I less than equal to j, then the next enumerators is exactly like this one here. So because this quadratic residuals are MDS code, we can compute this by looking at the AJE for J equals 0 to n minus 1 over 2. This is enough. And the previous theorem says that there is that n such that AJs are all constant. So we need to compute just the finite this code word for fixed, for the E bounded by N. But actually, here's an example. The binary the binary Hamming code has a minimum distance 5. But the finite projections have minimum distance 4. So all we need is the minimum, the weight numbers for d equals 4. And it's easy to compute this too. And then this will determine every other coefficients. And it gives you all this number of codules in of weight 5, 6, 7, 8 in every GPE. A 3-adic Golay code is again, we do this, find lambda and the formula for Q infinity. And then Q infinity is 12, 6, 7 code. So we need, again, and the minimum distance of the pilot projection is 6. So we just need this to these numbers. This will determine every number of code words in every extension. This is the 2-adic Golay code of length 24. This is, of course, has minimum distance 13, but the finite projection says 8, minimum distance 8. So we need to compute very many number of code words here. But this one's very fast. You can do it very fast. But I couldn't do it at the time, find these numbers. So Dr. Han found these numbers here. But you can see that because these two are equal, everything here in 1, and same here, equals the same here, these two are equal, and of course these are all equal. So from here to there, these are all 1, 2, 1, 4, 4, 4, etc. So once you have two equal number of code words, then everything determined. And here it appears that E equals 6 and 7. So this table determines every number of code words of given weight in every extension. It goes like this. And as I told you before, we can take P to be 3, 2, 3, and 13. So I take here P equals 3 in this case. We have tables like that. And this code has minimum distance 9, so it's better than the binary case. And finally, over the p equals 13, this has minimum distance 10, so it's even better. And this turns out that a very simple table like this, and it determines every number of code words. Thank you.